I really love liquid soap making and using my own handmade liquid soap, but to be honest with you, I don't make it too often. I find bar soaps a lot easier to make, they're a bit less fiddly, so I tend to just stick with them. However, there's something really satisfying about making your own liquid soap, squeezing it out of the bottle nice and neatly, washing your hands, all those things. It's just a nice, neat package. So in this video, I'm really keen to share with you my recipe for 100% olive oil, true liquid Castile soap. Lots of so-called liquid Castile soaps out there, Dr. Bronner's, are not really true Castile soaps in the way that most soap makers think of a Castile soap. They're made with coconut oil and palm oil and other oils in there. But a true Castile soap is 100% olive oil. It's a very gentle soap, whether it's made in bar form or liquid soap form. So that's what I'm sharing today. At the end, I'll show the finished soap and I'll do a bit of a lather test. So make sure you hang around for that. And as always, this video is for your information and hopefully your entertainment and enjoyment as well. But if you're new to soap making, please make sure that you watch my video on soap making safety. And really make sure that you understand what you're doing before you attempt any soap recipe. This recipe is really straightforward and it comes together beautifully. It has four ingredients: olive oil, water, distilled water or demineralized water is okay too, potassium hydroxide, which is the lye type that we're using, and a little bit of glycerin as well. And I'll explain that through the video why that works. So we'll get started and I'll show you how I make this soap. I start off by pouring my olive oil, or weighing it, straight into my crock pot. So this is a 3-liter slow cooker and it is perfect for this size batch of liquid Castile soap. I plug that in and turn it on high just because nothing is pre-warmed and I really want to warm up my oils to make this soap. And while that's warming up, I measure out my potassium hydroxide, 104 grams for this lye solution. And I've got my gloves and my goggles on. So make sure you know everything you need to know about soap making safety before you attempt any soap recipe. Check out the description box for more information about that. I use 156 grams of distilled water, or demineralized water in this case. And once you've got that poured out, you can slowly add in the potassium hydroxide and just stir it through gently until it dissolves. It'll take a little while, it'll be cloudy to begin with, and then it will become clear as it sits for a little bit. I also add glycerin in this recipe, 104 grams, and it acts as a solvent. It does other things too, but the main reason I'm adding it is to help this soap to saponify and trace faster than it would do without the glycerin. Liquid Castile soap made with 100% olive oil is notorious for separating. It takes a long time to blend and get it to come together, but the glycerin really speeds up that process. It also makes it a nicer soap to use as well. So the lye solution, just with the water and the potassium hydroxide, it's going in. My oils aren't really up to the right temperature yet, but it's okay to get started at this low temp because the cooker is on high and it'll come up pretty quickly. Then I'm adding the glycerin in as well at the beginning. If you don't have glycerin or you don't want to, you can just use water, and just check out the recipe on my website that's linked below. That gives all the details for the variations on how you can make this. And once everything's all together, those four ingredients, you can just start blending. That's really all there is to it to begin with. So this takes about 10 minutes to come together. You'll see at the beginning it's really oily and kind of yellowy, oily looking, and it will want to separate a fair bit. You've just got to keep blending and give your stick blender a rest every now and then so it doesn't burn out, and just blend for about 10 minutes until it gets really thick. And you're going to see, I did edit this a fair bit, so it jumps forward
But you can see it's still at the beginning now. It does have that really oily, separating, clear look on the top. But as you'll see the color starts to change. It starts to get lighter and more creamy and opaque looking. Once it starts to do that, you know you're on your way. I check the temperature as I go through this process as well, because I've still got that crock pot on high because I'm really wanting to bring it up to temperature, but I want to watch it too so it doesn't get too hot. Ideally, you want this soap to cook at around about 70 to 80 degrees Celsius, but not too much hotter than that, otherwise it'll scorch. See there the color change? It's looking really creamy and light. It's starting to emulsify there and it's getting a little bit thicker as well. I'm just checking the temperature again. What have I got there? 68 degrees Celsius. That's pretty warm. It's getting up there. And 157 Fahrenheit, that is. So I think at this point, I turn the slow cooker down to the low setting because you don't want it getting any hotter than 185 Fahrenheit or 85 Celsius. And you can see there, after about 10 minutes, it's really thick. It's actually blended perfectly now. It's really nice kind of pudding texture. It's a little bit grainy, but that's all right. As long as it's not separated and there's no obviously really oily bits floating around on the top, and it's nice and thick and homogeneous, then that's perfect. You don't have to stick blend anymore for this recipe. I just stir it around there a little bit. It's just kind of nice to play with. Show you what it looks like. It's quite thick. You can see it kind of plopping into the into the pot there. So you get an idea of the texture of what it should be like. Once you've got to this point, this recipe, it won't separate. Not if you're using the glycerin. If you weren't using the glycerin, you may get more separation and it would probably take a lot longer. But with the glycerin, it's quite fast. And I just scrape down the sides of my pot to make sure there's absolutely no little bits of unsaponified lye solution or anything on the side. And then I cover it up and I cook it on low heat. So I make sure the cooker is down on low or on the keep warm setting and set your timer for 20 to 30 minutes. This is after 10 minutes. I couldn't help myself. I had to check. you don't have to check it at 10 minutes, but I kind of felt like it. You can see the temperature there. It's 78 Celsius, which is 174 Fahrenheit. So that's a perfect temperature to cook this soap. Like I said before, you don't want it too hot because it will expand and oxidize and you'll get, fluffy, volcano-y soap, which you don't want. Keep it nice and moderate in the temperature department. And I'm just giving it a bit of a stir. Totally unnecessary, but quite enjoyable. For those of you who've made this kind of soap before, you'll know what I'm talking about. And then I just scrape down the sides again and put the lid back on. Leave it for a bit longer. So this is after 30 minutes in total. So I left it for another 20 minutes and you can see the color has changed. It's gone nice and translucent and Vaseline-y and it's just looking really beautiful. You can probably hear the cicadas and the dogs barking in the background. It's nighttime that I'm recording this voiceover, so a few background noises. But look at that paste. It's really nice. It's very soft paste because I use a fairly high liquid amount in this recipe, but it works well. Now, I'm pretty sure this is ready to dilute and that it's fully cooked, but I'm just going to check. So there's two ways that I check my liquid soap recipes. I first do a pH test because I want to make sure that this paste is completely cooked and saponified before I dilute it. So I've just dabbed a bit of water on there and you can see the paper is green. It's between 8 and 9 pH on my little pH paper strips. So that's perfect. And I also do a clarity test whereby I just get a little bit of the paste on a whisk or whatever and just mix it in with some distilled or demineralized water. This probably won't work with tap water. You need distilled water that doesn't have any minerals in it. And give it a shake, give it a really good mix. and you can't see because of all those bubbles. So you can get some isopropyl or any kind of alcohol and spray on there. It will get rid of the bubbles. And then if your soap is completely cooked, which I already know this is, but it will be nice and clear. It does have a few little lumps of paste still in there, but generally that solution is nice and clear. You can see my ring through there. If you know that's clear, it's done. So we're ready to dilute it now. This is as simple as it gets. I'm adding about 1.8 kilos or 1,850 grams of dilution water. Generally for this, I would start with 2:1. So 2 parts dilution water to 1 part paste, and then add more if you need to, because every olive oil is different and you may get more or less evaporation during your cooking process than I did. So just start conservative and then add more water later if you need to. There's a lot more detail about all of this in the website blog post of this recipe, which gives all the recipe details. So I did let this dilute and just sit there on low temperature for a few hours, and then after a couple of hours of it just sitting, I gave it a little bit of a help along with the stick blender, and that works really well. If there's still just a little bit of paste left, blend it all through and it really finishes off that dilution. You can see it's a bit frothy on the top, but I sprayed a bit more alcohol on the top and it's all clear now, perfectly diluted. This is still a bit runny because it's actually still a little bit warm. It does thicken up as it cools. And I also found it during my testing for this recipe, if you use extra virgin olive oil, you will get thicker soap, thicker Castile soap. I'm fairly sure this is the case. It seems to have been what's happened with me. I'm pretty sure there aren't other variables. I need to test it a bit more, but you could try using extra virgin olive oil and see how thick your soap goes. This batch is a little bit thinner than the previous one I did, which had more extra virgin in it, but you know, who knows. It does thicken up though as it cools. So I'm just pouring this into my bottles. I got about 2.7 liters of finished soap from this reasonably small batch, so a little goes a long way. And here I am just cleaning out my crock pot. It's like all olive oil soaps, whether they're in bar form or in liquid form, you don't get the greatest, most exciting lather, but it lathers up reasonably well, and I'm really happy with the soap. It's a lovely gentle soap. It's excellent for hand washing, and with the glycerin added too, it's a humectant, so it makes the soap leave the skin feeling a little bit more moist than other types of liquid soaps. So the one on the left there, this is the next morning, the one on the left has actually had some essential oils added, some lavender and tea tree, and it made it really thick. So don't thicken your soap before you add essential oils, because some of them can really thicken it up and you won't need to use any thickener. If you do want to thicken your soap though, and you're not using essential oils, have a look in the blog post because I explain how you can use a salt solution to thicken your soap if you really want to. But I really like this soap just as it is. It's gorgeous. So a bit of a lather test with the hands now. I need to keep working on my hand washing technique. Oh, goodness. So you see, a lovely soap. I really love this. Pure, 100%. Olive oil liquid Castile soap, the real deal. It, as I said, it's great for hand washing, but honestly, all of my liquid soap that I make, and usually they've got a lot of olive oil in them, I use them for everything except clothes washing. For washing my clothes in the washing machine, I use my laundry soap granules powder recipe. It's a lot more concentrated than liquid soap. Even coconut oil liquid soap I don't really like for washing my clothes, but I do use this in the kitchen, use it for hand washing in the bathroom and the kitchen. And you can see there I'm giving the sink a bit of a scrub. It works rather nicely even though it's still a mild soap. So that's about it, everybody. I hope you enjoyed that. I thoroughly enjoy bringing my soap recipe videos to you, and I am sharing the bits of knowledge that I have with you, but I also learn through every single one that I make, and it's a really valuable experience. So thanks all for your ongoing interest and support. Please share this video with others if you think they might be interested, and feel free to jump on my website and have a look at the written recipe. There's always lots more detail there, and if you've missed anything from the video, you can catch all the details there. If you'd like to support the work that I'm doing with Ellie's every day, feel free to head to my Buy Me a Coffee page, buymeacoffee.com/Ellie's Every Day. Any donation that you're able to make, small, large, medium, whatever, I greatly appreciate your support. So thanks, everybody. I look forward to seeing you again very soon.